What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. Today's video is to go over the 7 most popular tools that I use and most oftentimes carry around with me. Now, not all the time, but these are going to be the most popular tools that I use on pretty much a day-to-day basis with just about every project in some fashion. So if you're looking for some tools that you can keep in your RV, in your truck, or in your garage, just in the event something goes wrong, these are the tools that you might want to consider. So hang tight, I'll be right back. Now, let's start from the left and work our way over to the right. The first one is having a good quality power drill and driver. So I only show my drill right here. My driver is an impact driver, and I have a ton of these. I have the 12 volt model, which you're looking at here, and I also have the 20 volt model, mainly because the batteries are pretty much all interchangeable as long as you stay in the same volt range. So the 12 volt batteries will all change out to my other 12 volt DeWalt tools, and the 20 volt batteries will do the same with other 20 volt DeWalt tools. Now, when you buy power tools, you kind of find yourself in a situation that when you buy a specific brand, the batteries aren't really compatible with other brands, so you end up buying any other tool that you need in that same brand so it's compatible with the batteries, which is not a bad thing, but it does essentially lock you into a specific brand. I'm not a huge fan of DeWalt personally, but at the same time, I own a lot of DeWalt tools, and I guess because of that, I tend to see a higher failure rate of components. My biggest issue with DeWalt drills is the trigger and the button to reverse or go forward. This button always wears out on it. This is actually a new set because the set that I had, which was only about a year and a half old, the buttons on both of them went out. Anyways, this is their newest version of their 12 volt drill, and this is really cool because it's super short and compact. It's only maybe about 5 inches long, which is really nice if you're getting into a tight spot. This is the DCD701, and this uses the brushless motor, which is also really nice. Brushless motors will generally last quite a bit longer with the same battery, and they don't wear down as easily as your typical brushed motor. But that is the DeWalt drill that I use most often. Now, I have the larger ones, but I find myself going to this more compact one just because I can fit it into areas that you really can't fit those larger, longer drills into. So I have this one. I also have the driver for it as well, which is an impact driver. I like it. It's worked out well for me so far. So long as the trigger and the directional switch right here hold up, I'll be in good shape. I do like that they've come with better batteries with displays now, so I can actually see how charged my battery is. So that's nice. Next is this vice grip wire stripper. I use these all the time, and if you watch videos that I have of where I'm installing anything with 12 volt or anything with wiring, I usually go to these to strip the wire. Now, I come from an installation background, so I used to actually do car audio installation way back in the past, and these were my go-to tool. These are my Kleins, and they are absolutely fantastic for stripping wires, for crimping, making other connections. But if you're going to want to do a lot of wire stripping, it's good to have a dedicated wire stripper. Pick these up at Lowe's. They're not that expensive, and they work very, very well in stripping most of the shielding off of wires for you. Next is the zip tie. I know a lot of people already go to these. These are a tool because you can use these in so many different ways to accomplish so many different tasks, whether you're cleaning up wiring, whether you're trying to hold something in place, whether you're securing something. This is just a great, great tool. You can buy them in packs of 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, or smaller packs of 50. I usually buy these in the really large packages simply because I like to have these on hand because they work in so many different ways for so many different things that I'm always trying to do. So, big fan of zip ties. I carry multiple different sizes and lengths of them as well, and I even carry them in different colors just in case I want them to blend in with something I'm installing them on. Super cheap. You need to carry zip ties with you. I think most people probably already do. Next is the Klein wire stripper crimping tool. I absolutely love these. I have about 4 pairs of these, and I keep them everywhere. They're not inexpensive, though. These are going to cost you generally between about $25 and $30, and they work so well. They crimp well. They cut wires well. I mean, if you've been in installation, if you've done wiring in the past, you probably have a set of these. The Klein, in my opinion, are the best at what they do with building these. These are made in the USA, very, very robust, and this pair right here I've probably had for 15 years, and they still look like new. So next are these crescent pliers. These are absolutely great. They're adjustable pliers. They work exceptionally well. They are super robust. They're made in America. They are my go-to pliers. I use these for just about everything, and I bypass all the other pliers that I have collected unless I absolutely need one or I need someone else to be using them as well. These are a beast of pliers. I got three or four of these, and they've never failed me. They just work really well. They're really smooth. There's not a lot of slop in them, and I don't have to worry about them ever binding up to where it's hard to adjust. These things have just been really rock solid, and I'm a big fan of these. But these are the Crescent pliers, adjustable pliers. A lot of use out of these. Next is one that I did a video on a while back, and what's in this box is probably my single most used accessory or tool that I carry in my truck, and I absolutely love them. Now, these are made by a brand off Amazon called Nyco, I believe, and I think it was about $25 is what I paid for them. I did a video on these a while back, and I put a link, but I'll also put a link in this video. These are sockets, and they're reversible, which means this is one size, and this is one size. And you can see the markings on them. 7/8, 15/16, 22 millimeter, 21 millimeter, 3/4 inch, 13/16, 17 millimeter, and 19 millimeter. So basically what you do is you take the socket size that you need, you drop your little adapter here into it, that's a half inch, and then you simply attach it to your impact driver, which is going to be the last thing we talk about. And if I need to use the 17 millimeter, I'll simply move this to the opposite side. This is such a great and handy tool to carry around with you. Like I said, I use these a ton. I use these for just about every application where I need sockets. Now, I know there, of course, are going to be other socket sizes you might need for different applications, but 8 out of 10 times, this is what I go to. Whether I was installing the goose box on the fifth wheel, swapping out to the new goose box, taking lug nuts off of a wheel, whatever I'm doing, I've been able to pretty much do with this set. I am prepared with some additional sockets just in the event I have to loosen or fasten something that uses a different size nut or bolt, but this is my go-to kit. I use it again for 8 out of 10 jobs that require loosening or fastening bolts. Love this kit. Finally, this is actually a replacement to a impact driver that I had before. This impact wrench is awesome. This is the DeWalt 20 volt brushless. This thing has like 300 or 400 pound feet of torque. This is really a very powerful tool. I had one that was slightly less powerful, and I ran into situations where it wasn't adequately loosening or tightening fasteners, and I wanted something a little bit bigger. So I actually upgraded to this one's big brother, which is actually significantly bigger. But what I found out was even a short stint of pulling the trigger on this thing, I would over tighten fasteners. So this one falls right in the middle of the smaller one that I featured last time and the larger one that I also got. And this one works really, really well. It, again, fastens to like 300 or 500 pound feet. I can't remember. I'll put the number in this video so you can actually know specifically how strong this is. This thing is an absolute beast. This is the DCF894. Absolutely a great impact driver. This thing is super cool. So I use these with this. I use these on just about every project that I have to tighten something or loosen something with a pair of pliers. This is for every wiring need. I carry these everywhere. I use these for everything, and I have a set just about everywhere just in case I need to go to them. Zip ties, you know, these speak for themselves. These vice grip wire strippers and the 12 volt DeWalt drill driver combo. Absolutely love it. I probably have 20 or 30 of the large 5 and 6 amp battery packs for my 20 volts, and I probably have 10 of these 12 volt battery packs for my small drills. So all of these tools with 12 volts, I can swap batteries on, I can keep chargers everywhere, just like I can for my 20 volt. And the nice thing is the new DeWalt 20 volt chargers will also charge the 12 volt batteries as well, which is really nice. Anyways, guys, I'll put a link in the description of this video to all of these products because, again, you may need other tools. There may be other things you need for different applications, but these happen to be the 7 things that I use most often. And that's what some people wanted to know. Guys, if you haven't had a chance, I'd appreciate it if you took a moment, subscribe to my channel, give me a thumbs up, and we'll talk to you again very soon.